Hello everyone. The topic of study here is ERP, that is Address Resolution Protocol. This protocol is formed at the network layer in case of TCP/IP protocol suite, but the main functionality of this can be found in the link layer. Here, what it does is, this ERP protocol, it maps an IP address to a logical link address. And it is going to accept the IP address from the IP protocol and map that IP address into the corresponding link layer address. And then it passes that address to the data link layer. Here you can find the operation of ERP, that is Address Resolution Protocol. You can find there are four networks. There are LAN networks, and here you have a system A, system B, and you have the remaining two systems. Here system A, it has a network address as well as the logical address, and this system A, it wants to send some data to the system B. When it wants to send some data to the system B, system A does not have the logical address of system B. So it's going to send a request message to all the nodes in the network. It is, what this request message contains is, it is looking for the link layer address of a node with the IP address as link. So in this request message, it's going to broadcast this message to all the nodes in the network, and it's going to request that the system which has the network address as N2, it has requested to send its logical address. So here system A, it has broadcasted the request message to all the nodes in the network. As soon as the system B receives that request, it's going to reply back sending that I have the logical address as L2 for the network address of N2. So the reply is here, I am a node and my link layer address is L2. And this reply is a unicast. It's going to send the reply only to the system A. And they both can communicate directly with each other, and they can exchange the information using unicasting. So the system A next time is going to send message only to the system B. Here we have the packet format of ARV protocol. Here, name of the fields, they are almost self-explanatory. The first one is hardware type. It is going to define the type of link layer protocol that is being used. Usually it is Ethernet, and that value is specified as 1. Next we have the protocol type, and this is going to define the network layer protocols, that is IPv4 protocols. Next we have the source hardware and source protocols addresses, and these are of variable length, that is source IP address and destination, source IP address and source MAC addresses. Similarly, you have destination hardware addresses and destination protocol addresses fields, and usually destination hardware address, it is empty in case of request because it does not know the hardware or link layer address, that is the logical address is not known. So it is going to be empty in case of request pool. But when you are actually transferring the data, even that field has to be filled. And the last one is destination protocol address, to which protocol is used during the transmission, that is also mentioned there in the destination protocol address. And almost all the destination protocols are network layer protocols. There is one thing here we need to consider, that the question we can ask here is, why a system A cannot broadcast a frame to find a link layer address of the system B? Why can't a system A send the datagram to the system B? Here, in case of this, system A, it's going to send a broadcast message for the request. And instead of that, it can directly broadcast what kind of data it wants to send to the system B. But it is not the efficient way of using this protocol, and it's going to reduce the efficiency and it causes the congestion. So, every time system A does not perform the broadcasting of message, it's just going to broadcast a request message to all the nodes, and as soon as it gets the reply, it will send the data to the only particular node which has replied. And as soon as it gets both logical as well as the network address, it will send the data to that particular system through unicast. And here we have an example. A host with an IP address N1 and a MAC address is L1, that is the system name, has a packet to send to another host with an IP address as N2. Here we can find the IP address as N2 and physical address is L2, which is not known to the A. So how the two hosts that they are going to communicate? They are communicated using the request and response messages. Here it is a request message. In request message, destination is written as M, because we are going to broadcast this message, so it is being written as M, and the source which is sending this request message, that is a system A, and it is requesting to know the logical address of L2, that is the system B logical address. So the data or the request is broadcasted. As soon as the system B receives, we can check here L1, N1, they are the source, that is the system A's IP address as well as the MAC address, that is link layer and network layer address. And as it does not know the link layer address of the other device, all are set to 0. And next it is the network address of the system B. And in the reply message, these fields are filled. Here the L2 is the logical address of the system B and N2 is the network address of the system B, and this is the reply message that has been sent to the A, and the destination here is A and the source here is B. Thank you.